What should we do next, Holmes?
Are the steam rooms on the other side?
Good day to you, Mr. Phillips. My name is Sherlock Holmes, and this is my colleague, Dr. Watson. Would you be so kind as to answer our questions?
Certainly, sir.
Please tell us the chain of events from the start of your day. Everything that you can remember. The slightest detail may be of importance.
Very well, sir. I came in at 6:30 this morning, and I opened the baths. I made sure that the room was clean, and I prepared the towels. The brazier was still burning.
There was a fire burning all night?
Yes. Sir Gregory ordered me to light the brazier yesterday. It takes some time until the room is fully heated. The gentleman had a meeting at 9 o'clock this morning. I wanted everything to be perfect. They'd been in the steam room for 20 minutes when I suddenly heard shouting. I ran to the door, but it was closed. I couldn't open it. So I ran out to the street to call for the police. One constable came up, and then there were others, and they picked the lock. Then Inspector Lestrade came along, and he told us that nothing should be touched.
Did you receive any other visitors this morning?
No one. Until these gentlemen arrived. Sir Gregory was the first. And then, while we were discussing work details, Sir Rodney and Mr. Blinkhorn arrived, and Mr. Garrow followed.
What happened after that?
I waited until they'd all entered the steam room, then I returned to the hall. The changing room door was open, so I should hear if they needed anything.
You would have heard if someone had entered or left the steam room.
Certainly, sir. These doors make a lot of noise.
Any progress, Mr. Holmes?
Unopened. It was intended to be enjoyed after the steam session. Champagne for a special occasion. An ice bucket to keep the champagne chilled. Expensive clothes, belonging to one of the men from the steam room. These clothes belong to one of the suspects from the steam room. Clothes belonging to one of the suspects. Death with a peculiarly Roman piquancy.
Like the one you almost had an hour ago.
Let us forget about that.
There was only one hit from the weapon. It pierced the right eye straight through to the brain. Death would have been instantaneous.
Hmm. The wound should not have bled so profusely. This pool is rather large. Some dirt or earth. I'll take a sample. Look, Watson. He was wearing a ring. He very likely removed it before the steam session.
The death is very recent, between 30 minutes to 1 hour ago.
I think we have found all that we can here, taking into consideration the abysmal lighting. Constable, we have finished with the body.
We don't have many leads here.
What concerns me is that we still have to find the murder weapon.
Mr. Holmes?
Please have the body removed without disturbing anything else in the room.
All right, Mr. Holmes.
I was wondering, Holmes, it's fairly reckless to carry out a murder inside a closed chamber. Why do you suppose they did it?
There are a great many possibilities. The murderer was in a hurry. Or he is an artist. Or a ghost. Or he wanted to ensure that I'd be brought in on the case.
Probably the latter. You are ridiculous, do you know that? I'm always wondering what's on your mind, Holmes.
I should check this blood sample at Baker Street. This key was covered in blood. I should ask Phillips about it. With the steam on, I'm unable to see even a few feet away. The brazier is still burning. The heat here is extreme. I will need something to pick up this melted metal. It is too hot. I cannot reach into it. One lens is cracked, probably due to the temperature of the brazier. These lenses are for myopia. The wearer is short-sighted. Blood traces wiped on the towel.
It's horrible. So Rodney East, dead. Can't we speak about it somewhere else?
I'm in shock. I don't want to talk.
It's horrible. I can't talk at the moment.
Mr. Holmes?
The grid cannot be removed. The weapon is nowhere to be found. With the steam on, I'm unable to see even a few feet away. Thank you.
Mr. Holmes, I should like to take the suspects to the yard. You can interrogate them there. Any objections?
None, Lestrade. How many people have keys to the steam room?
We have just the one key for now, which Sir Gregory gave to me.
So, this morning you opened the steam room, and then?
I put the key inside my desk, but when they called, I couldn't find it. It had disappeared. I don't know where it is.
Did you leave the baths at any time or receive any visitors?
No, sir. I did not.
Did you leave the...
No, sir. I did not.
Did you...
No, sir. I did not.
Did you leave the baths at any time or receive any visitors?
No, sir. I did not.
Did you...
No, sir. I did not.
Did you...
No, sir. I did not.
You are not telling the truth, Mr. Phillips. You left your work this morning, and you went to the post office, where you dispatched a telegram at around 7:30.
But how could you... No, I...
The telegram was for someone in Manchester.
Mr. Holmes, it's I'll tell you everything. I left the baths at 7:20. My sister wrote to me yesterday, and she needed a reply, or our mother is unwell. I was away for 20 minutes. And I closed the baths on my way out.
Did you receive a reply from your sister?
No, she wasn't meant to. I just told her to pawn my old school uniform so that she could pay for the medication.
Did you check to see if the key was still in your desk when you returned?
No, I didn't. Please, Mr. Holmes, don't tell the police about this. Sir Gregory would give me the sack. I need this job.
I see. There is a bottle of champagne on ice in the changing room. Do you have any idea who left it there?
There is? Are you quite certain? I didn't pay any attention. Do you believe that it's important?
Mr. Holmes?
This area serves as Sir Rodney Bentcliffe's workshop. Tools used by archaeologists in their research. I will need these tongs. Plate. What should be done with it? Archaeological findings. Old clay pots with numbers inscribed upon them. Archaeological findings. Old clay pots with numbers inscribed upon them. Glass plate negatives. A remarkable method for recording ancient civilizations. A glass plate negative is missing. It is a glass plate negative of an Egyptian statue.
Wonder how this could have happened.
Yes, it is somewhat treacherous. Fortunately, I am unscathed. To where does this corridor lead?
To the frigidarium, the coal room.
Barely unscathed and by a very small margin. And treacherous is an understatement. Those stones weigh tons. We won't move them.
It does not matter. If our investigation requires it, we shall ask for them to be removed. I should analyze this melted metal.
These baths are becoming sinister.
This is where I keep my post. This is where I keep my post. That is not the one I need. That is not the one I need. That is not the one I need.
By the eye, he was punished, for he saw that he was not worthy. Dreadful.
on the sofa for the third time today. Well, don't be surprised if Watson sits on you again. Pyrite, otherwise known as fool's gold. Selenite. White clay particles. Interesting. According to the color and its composition, I deduce that this sample is white clay. Now, I need to find which area near London this sample belongs to. The sample of dirt belongs to the White London Clay region, located near the city of St. Albans. This is a piece of metal taken from a brazier. It appears to be silver, but I need to be sure. If it is silver, it will be possible to melt it, since silver's melting point is at around 900 degrees Celsius. Let us compare this sample with a silver penny by testing it with acid. If it changes color to match the result of a reaction with a silver coin, then it is silver. I must take a pipette and place several drops of acid upon the samples. The reaction is the same red stain. It is silver, Britannia silver quality. Let us analyze this blood sample. This blood has not coagulated well. It seems very liquid. That is strange. Let us see what is inside it. Hydrogen peroxide will bring any foreign matter to the surface. I must take a pipette and place several drops of hydrogen peroxide. Water. This blood is heavily diluted with water.
What should we do next, Holmes?
Good day to you, Mr. Holmes.
An old and rather dirty coin. This ring was most likely the one that Sir Rodney wore. He removed it before entering the steam room. I see the join. This ring was repaired, and quite badly too, with silver. An Egyptian symbol. It is a very old jewel.
Why on earth would they wear such a ring?
A very pertinent question. A hand-drawn map. Rodney Bentcliffe's notebook. It may contain something of interest. The last pages were torn out. We must find a way of retrieving Sir Rodney's last lines. Watson, please prevent anyone from entering the room. But first, fetch me a pencil. To begin with, a few strokes of the pencil will be enough. I don't want to damage the traces. And then to gently smudge the leftover pencil marks with a handkerchief. I'm sure that Watson won't mind if I use his.
Mr. Holmes! The coroner... But what are you doing? Tampering with the evidence?
I prefer to make them talk. Today, I almost found it. This date will go down in history. Sir Rodney was about to make an outstanding discovery.
Wonderful.
I could retrieve only the final words. The rest of it is lost. Perhaps the autopsy will assist us in that matter.
I'm not sure that I can allow you to inspect the body now.
I am sure that you must, Constable.
Well.
An ordinary pencil. File with herbs. Do you know what it is, my dear fellow?
It's the St. John's wort flower, Holmes. It's commonly used as a drug against melancholia. However, an overdosage might lead to a rash or even hallucinations.
When Garrow found Sir Rodney dead, he wiped the blood upon himself. A fountain pen with solid gold trim. Sir Gregory Pitkin's visiting card. An embroidered silk handkerchief.
What should...
Locked.
Good day to you, Mr. Holmes.